Welcome back to BCTV. I'm Luke McCauley.
And I'm Trent Zimmelman.
That hype video has me excited for Riverfront on October 7th.
More excited than KU fans after a winning record?
There's definitely a lot to be excited about this fall.
Yeah, one of the things I'm most excited for is the revamped Community Cups.
We sent some people to interview the Dean to break them down for us.
I'm Thomas.
And I'm Cash.
And today we're going to be interviewing the Community Deans. Let's get it.
Who are you?
I'm Coach Lager.
And what is your community?
St. John Paul II.
And what is your community trophy?
We have the JP2 belt.
And why is it that?
We actually kind of talked about getting one last year and just never really made it happen. So then this year we were like, let's do it. Let's go for it. So we got one made.
Okay.
Who are you?
I'm Tony Rosales, the Dean of Dominic Savio Community.
What is your trophy?
We have a nice belt. Championship belt, wrestling belt, boxing belt, whatever you want to call it.
And why did you choose it?
Well, Dominic Savio was young, and he's the patron saint of juvenile delinquents, so we know that he's a fighter. So we wanted to kind of something to reflect that. And plus, it's just cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Who are you?
My name's Miss Johnson.
And what community are you in?
For Max Colby, reigning champs.
And what's your community's trophy?
All right, our trophy, we have St. Max Colby statue here, and then we have our Colby crown, and we have our Colby crown because Our Lady appeared in a vision to Max Colby, offered him two crowns, one white for purity, one red for martyrdom, and he chose both. So that's what you see reflected here.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Who are you?
I'm Mr. Rock.
And what is your community?
Philip Neary.
What is your community trophy?
So we came up with a cup of excellence for Philip Neary. We honestly had big goals of doing a big flaming heart, but you have to be realistic with yourselves, and we knew that wasn't going to happen. So a cup it is.
And why is this the trophy?
Well, honestly, we kind of exhausted our other options. And who doesn't want a cup? I remember watching hockey as a kid going, I need a Stanley Cup. You could pour things in there like cereal and enjoy it. So it's a dual purpose.
Thank you.
Who are you?
I'm Mr. Manns.
What is your community?
St. Sebastian.
What is your community trophy?
So for our community trophy, we are doing the Sebastian Shield. It's going to be a wood-carved shield that kind of represents our community's unique core values of strength, endurance, and inspiration. And also, St. Sebastian was a Roman soldier, and so we felt like the shield would be something that kind of represents his being a soldier and kind of a defender of the faith. He was a convert to Christianity, and he also brought many with him. So we think the shield's going to turn out pretty cool. And our own community coordinator, Cooper Bussing, is working on it. He's building it with his dad right now. So there's going to be a little bit of a personal touch to our community trophy.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name is Ms. Shippers.
What's your community?
I am the Dean of St. Teresa of Calcutta.
What's Calcutta's trophy?
St. Teresa of Calcutta's trophy is a statue of St. Teresa of Calcutta.
And why did you choose it?
Well, I actually bought this last year before some of these other communities were a little bit more creative with their trophies. But I initially thought, okay, it's a statue of St. Teresa and it'd be something that, visually that the kids could see if their house had this in their house.
Thank you.
Who are you?
Hi, I'm Miss Loxton.
What community are you?
St. Teresa of Lisieux.
What is your community's trophy?
This is our community trophy. So we have a medal rose that gets passed around to whoever's in lead for Community Cup.
And why is it that?
We do a lot of symbolism of the rose with St. Therese because she says she wants to spend her heaven doing good on earth, and she's going to shower the earth with roses. So we incorporate the rose theme into pretty much everything we do.
That's good.
Who are you?
I am Mrs. Quintana.
What community are you in?
St. Andre Bassett.
What is your community trophy?
My community trophy is the Golden Crutch. The Golden Crutch was chosen because St. Andre Bassett was buried in Montreal, Canada, at St. Joseph's Oratory, and he is still there right now, and it is lined with crutches of people who walk in with crutches and leave able to walk. So there's a lot of miracles that are attributed to him. So that's why we chose the Golden Crutch.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wow, those were creative.
Yes, very unique.
Back to you guys.
I like how each community has their own unique prize, except for Domsov, who stole from JP2.
I think you mean JP2, who stole from Domsov.
Let's set our differences aside for now and move on to homecoming.
There's a lot to unpack from last week. That's why we had Ben and Taj recap it all.
Hi, I'm Taj Mary Bowie Vitolas.
And I'm Ben Johnson.
Here's a recap of Bishop Carroll's 2022 homecoming week.
Let's take a look at what all the students did to get into the homecoming spirit.
That sure looks like a blast.
Can't wait to see what they come up with next year.
This is BCTV, and I'm Taj Mary Bowie.
And I'm Ben Johnson.
Signing off.
What an eventful week that was.
It was, Your Majesty.
I was king last week. This week, I'm just Luke again.
You should see me on the dance floor. I was busting some moves.
Speaking of moves, let's move on to sports.
Hello, Bishop Carroll. My name is Dalton Hurst, and I'm here to get you updated on Bishop Carroll's athletics. The girls' golf team placed second overall in the Bishop Carroll Invitational at Rolling Hills. Kiera Ronzik placed fourth. Bella Jones placed seventh, and Ella Kirshen placed 15th. Now on to boys' soccer, who are 4-5 after winning their latest game against Southeast 3-0. Their next game is October 4th against Northwest. Now running into cross country, with the girls placing 19th and the boys placing 16th in their latest tournament as of filming this broadcast. Trent Zimbelman placed 44th, and Thomas Martin placed 60th for the boys. And for the girls, Abigail Mayer placed 46th, and Brooke Martin placed 63rd. Their next race is on Saturday the 8th. The volleyball team traveled up to Kansas City to compete in their invitational tournament. Their overall record was 2-3, and took 4th out of the 6 teams, making their overall record now 12-2. The girls' tennis team recently competed in a match against Cape and Mount Carmel, winning 5-4, with it coming down to the last match to decide. Now on to football. Their most recent game was against North High at Heights, pulling out the victory. The record is now 3-2. Their next game this week is the Holy War versus Capen, and it's being played downtown at Riverfront Stadium, so make sure to pack the stands and be loud. That's all the time I have for sports, but make sure to get out and support all of our fall sports team. For BCTV, I'm Dalton Hurst.
I can't wait to see what's in store for our teams the rest of the season.
Another team at Bishop Carroll put on quite the show last Friday.
And so did you, Trent, in that onesie.
Hey, that thing was comfy.
Let's send it down to Avery and Sammy to give us an inside look.
Hey guys, I'm Avery McDowell.
And I'm Samantha Parks, and today we're going to be showing you the behind the scenes of our four-girl homecoming pep rally dance practice. So let's dance!
We asked a few of the senior boys what their favorite dance moves are. Here's Walt Gray and Tate Blazy's favorite moves.
Trent, do you feel ready to perform this dance at the pep rally?
I do. We've had 3 practices. We've put in countless hours of work. I think that with all the practice we've put in, it'll be a good show and we'll do everything right.
They ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
Loud and proud.
OBC Pump! Woo!
You'll need to work on those moves.
What do you mean? I thought I killed it out there.
On that note, that's all we have for today. I'm Tim Zimmerman.
And I'm Luke McCauley. Thanks for watching.